Dear students, in today's session we are going to discuss another topic in chapter 4 inflation, which is known as types of inflation. Let us go into the types in a bit detail. So there are prominently 5 types of inflation. We would be discussing them one by one. One is known as cost push inflation, which we will discuss in detail with the help of diagram. Second is known as demand pull inflation. Again, we are going to discuss it with the help of a diagram. Third type of inflation is known as currency inflation, and it is known so because this inflation is induced by printing of more currency notes by the central bank. So if the quantity of currency notes printed by a central bank increases at a given period of time, there would be more money supply in the economy, leading to an increase in the price level and leading to inflation. Fourth type is known as deficit induced inflation. So whenever the central government is facing a government budget deficit, or what you know as fiscal deficit, where the expenditures are higher than revenues, then an alternative source of raising revenue or raising finance for financing the expenditure is to print more currency. So if the government wants to exercise this option, then it would try to pump in more money, leading to additional printing of money by the central bank. And again, because of printing of more money, there would be an increase in money supply, leading to inflation. And this inflation is being induced by deficit, budget deficit or fiscal deficit, and that is why it is known as deficit induced inflation. Fifth type is known as credit inflation. Now, credit inflation is very different. It is basically occurring because of an active role of commercial banks in trying to find borrowers. So ideally, people who need loans should themselves approach banks. However, in certain cases, banks try to find out their prospective borrowers, in which case they may be calling up the people, or they may be trying to contact directly or indirectly their prospective borrowers, and may ask them if they need any loan. So if loans are granted by banks are in excess to what actually the economy needs, then there would be more money supply in the economy, leading to an increase in the price level. And this increase in the price level is being induced by banks, and basically the credit provided by the bank, and that is why it is known as credit inflation. This picture is just for reference purposes, because these are not the technical types or the technical terminologies used in inflation. However, just for understanding, you can see that which category of inflation is known as hyperinflation. So it is generally when the inflation is greater than 1000%. Which category are we there currently? So our inflation currently is between 3 to 10%, so we are in the Hawking inflation. So this graph has been taken from internet, and that's why it is only for reference purposes. The technical terms are not the ones which are used in economics in general. So let's quickly move to the first type of inflation, which I said we would be using a diagram in order to understand it. So this is known as cost push inflation. And as you can see in the diagram, we have taken on y-axis price level, and on x-axis we have taken national income, or what you alternatively know as real GDP or total output in an economy. So this inflation is caused by increase in the cost of production. Cost of production basically implies an increase in the prices of inputs, which are the part of the production process. You can assume that supposedly the price of crude oil rises, which may be an input in the production process, or the price of sugar rises, or the price of say a tire rises, which is an input in the production of an automobile. Similarly, there is a possibility that the price of say wheat flour rises. So any input you can imagine in your mind. And if those inputs are becoming costlier, the general response of producers is they tend to reduce the production and wait until the input prices fall. So for the time being, when production is stagnated or reduced, you will see a fall, a reduction in the supply curve of the producers. So we can see it in the diagram. We have a negatively sloped demand curve, which we call as aggregate demand, and a positively sloped aggregate supply curve. At the original level, the original quantity being produced in the economy is presented by the symbol Y, and this quantity of output is being sold at a price level represented as P. Now, when the input costs rise, producers may try to cut down production, which will also reduce the supply. So, a reduction in the supply curve is being represented in the diagram as a leftward shift from AS to AS1. This is leading to an increase in the price level from P to P1 and a reduction in the total output in the economy from Y to Y1. So, this change in price level or inflation has been brought about by a change in the cost of production, and that is why it is known as cost push inflation. Let us now move to the second type, which is known as demand pull inflation. So, for demand pull inflation, again we have a similar diagram. We have plotted price level on the y-axis and real GDP or national income, or what you know as total output in the economy, on x-axis. Now, a negatively sloped demand curve is being represented by AD, and the original aggregate supply curve is being represented by AS. And supposingly, there is an increase in the demand. Now, aggregate demand can increase because of multiple reasons. So, it can increase either if the total income in the hands of the people increase, or the per capita income increases, or if the government, which is also a consumer, increases its expenditure on goods and services. So, there can be multiple reasons for increasing aggregate demand. Whenever aggregate demand increases, it results into a rightward shift in the diagram. So a shift from AD to AD dash is reflecting this increase in aggregate demand, and supply remaining constant. If supply is not increasing simultaneously, only demand is increasing, it will lead to increase in price level, and also it will lead to increase in the total output produced in the economy. Demand pull inflation can occur because of the four factors which you have already studied as part of methods of measurement of GDP. So in the expenditure approach, you had all those four factors which are responsible for increasing aggregate demand. So it could be because of higher consumption expenditure, or higher investment, or higher exports, or higher government expenditure, or because of all the four factors increasing simultaneously. So aggregate demand can increase due to these four factors. So basically, in this session we try to understand the types of inflation, and we will connect again with your doubts. Till then, take care of your health. Thank you.